nice and crisp 55 degrees at 8 a.m. here in Mammoth. And we are headed down to the shop. We're going to check on Ian and Dan. They are fabricating some steel. We're going to set a steel beam today. So that's kind of on the agenda. I got Mike. Brian's back from Alaska. He just got back last night. So Mike, Brian, and Clayton are working in June Lake. And then the rest of the guys are up at Main Lodge. And I think we have a few guys over at Starwood. So it's a lot of stuff going on today. So let's see how the day goes. So here's a couple things we're working on in the shop. What he's got going on out there right now is part of this Mammoth frame right here, the tabs on it. So a little metal fabrication to throw in, a little dirt work in the morning, some metal fab in the afternoon. Ian's over here welding this up. Looking good. All right, we got to scooch in the sawhorses here because we need to flip that last beam. So Ian's going to hop in a forklift and I'm going to help him. I'm going to get some stickers. You want to set it right here? We're just scooch this side in a little, huh? That might actually do it. I get this one over a little. You want to stand it up like that? We good?
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. Yeah. She's got to weld the nipples on top now. Oh, yeah, the gussets.
Yeah, and then mark out my top, and then
do your staggered.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah. If you look at the top of that link, it's got a cotter pin hole for it, as does that one. Yeah. So that's just the master link.
Okay.
So I think we can just take and
punch those out.
Yeah, I just want to soak those with some
some
material. Let me grab a
glove.
Yeah, grab
some
gloves.
Did he say what this was off of?
I want to see. He said it was off a Ditch Witch.
Ditch Witch, huh?
Yeah.
So it looks like the master link.
Master link, so that
the pin for the master link.
Yeah.
Sure.
Well, this is the half link.
Uh huh.
And then the master link is the piece that came through here and through here. So
you can see it's frozen up right there.
Yeah. So we'll see if we can get some.
I might try. I'm gonna punch that out.
Yeah, I mean, if they
well, what we'll do is
if they want us to reinstall it too, like, that's like no problem. Mm-hmm. Where are they working at right now?
They're working up by Juniper Springs.
Doing some directional.
Yeah, they're running
like underground utilities.
Underground. I think he said they were putting in 2-inch pipe.
This isn't a local contractor, is it?
No, they're out of, I think they're out of Sacramento.
Yeah, that's what I saw the area code.
What is that?
So we're going to try to get this chain fixed up for these guys. Going to get these pins pushed
out.
Yeah,
we'll try and get these pins pushed out.
See if we can find a replacement pin for
well,
it.
He's got the pin coming. The pin
does he? Okay, good.
Is being delivered to their shop in Sacramento, and then it's coming over with a crew that are coming over to do some work.
Nice.
So it should all work out.
Got some of it out.
So we got this thing pinned up here.
What's that?
With the clamp.
Yeah.
Did you get one out?
I got most of it out. I'm just working on this last one here. And I got that cotter pin out.
So it seems like they're coming out fairly easy.
Yeah, this one's a little tough, but
I would probably go ahead and pull this just so that we can clean it. I mean, it feels like it's moving good now.
Okay.
But let's go ahead and get it out just so we can kind of wire brush it all and clean it up. And
all right. Okay, so now we're going to head up and check on Dan and the boys up at the Racquet Club. They are rebuilding the tennis court perimeter fencing. So let's go see what's going on up there. Little bacon, got that going. Got some eggs getting ready. A little bit of fruit, start off the day. Gotta eat healthy. I guess the bacon's not super healthy, but I'm gonna add a little bit of avocado and a little bit of pico. And I'll do my tortilla here. So I'll make a nice little egg and bacon breakfast burrito. It's gonna really hold me over through lunch. Let me see it. Here, ready? All right, guys, we got the Rangers over here in the driveway. Gonna get them all cleaned up. Don't forget, We're giving this thing away on Labor Day, so you guys definitely want to get entered for a chance to win that. We've got quite a few entries so far. I'm not sure exactly how many. I told you we were going to cap it at 5,000. We're not quite there yet. So whatever we end up with by Labor Day weekend is what we're going with. If it's under 5,000, then you're going to have better chances of winning this thing. But for now, you need to get over to the site, mammothmountainlife.com, check out the store, and enter to win. Also, this thing, I know a lot of people did say we were going to tear it all up, but as you can see, it literally has see how many miles it has on it. .9 miles. Okay. This thing's only got 43 miles on it. It may have another 10 or 15, 20 miles on it, but I can tell you this, it's going to probably have less than 100 miles on it. So it's a brand new 2023 Ranger XP. It's got the dual overhead cam. So this thing is super nice. We've tested it quite a bit, took it on a couple rides, and it just performs excellent. I mean, you can still see the nipples are on the tires, so it does need to be washed up, which we're going to get her all cleaned up for the Mammoth motocross race, and we'll have it out there at the races, so you'll be able to see it in person out there. But this thing's mint. Not one thing wrong with it. Great condition, brand new unit. We're giving it away on Labor Day weekend, so don't miss out on that. Make sure you join. Follow us on Instagram. Follow us on Facebook. And check out mammothmountainlife.com.
Lift over there so we can straighten out those posts. We're getting it up there with the lift. There she is, right where we want her.
Okay, we're on our way up to the racket club here. Check out this fencing job that Dan and Alex and the boys are doing. They got the scissor lift up here the other day. So I know we have a bronze elk it's an elk statue that's coming into town, and we're going to be setting that with the crane in the next couple days. But here's something a little different. This is a plastic unicorn. Looks like it's made out of old plastic 55-gallon drums or something like that. Interesting. Okay, well, they're at lunch, but looks like the progress is pretty good. I got one pole over there left to straighten. These all look nice and straight all the way around. They got the caps on. So next step, we're gonna get all this top rail installed. And then we'll get Dan over here. I'm sure he's gonna straighten this up, this post up over here. Looks like he was doing a little welding and stuff. Yeah, for the most part, everything looks pretty straight. Got a couple that need to be straightened up down that way, but this side over here is looking really good. So this thing should be done hopefully today. Might have a little time in it tomorrow, but I think we're doing pretty good. So we're pretty much right on schedule, right on track budget wise. So that's nice. So here's more carnage from the snow of last year. This one here collapsed, and it just took the whole side of this building off. That was the front door leading into the home that is no longer here. So you can just see right down into the living area here. It just completely took off this whole side of the building.
Spread this out and maybe start laying fabric out after we get this all dialed in. Alright, so we got this last layer of rock down in here. Got it all smoothed out. Now we're gonna get the felt. Come out here and lay the felt down. And then start bringing the class 2 base in. Probably be a little slow process, but can't do it really fast. This looks good though. Everything's about grade. Okay, so I was checking out the track on this Big X, and one of the tracks, the pin slid out. So we need to get that pin back in the hole. And it looks like it was something that was welded, but so we got it hooked up to the little mini X right now. We pulled the track back into place to where we can pound that pin back in. We'll have to pound it back in from this side. Let's see what we got here. Yep, there's the pin sticking out right there. So we'll get that thing in pound it back in for now. That way we don't lose the track. That wouldn't be good. Let me get on that other side.
Probably gonna pull it a little bit more.
Yep. Yep, we gotta suck it up a little bit more and so we can get that pin in there. All right, we got our first load of the class 2 base. And we just started rolling out this fabric. We got to get it rolled out all the way across. Over there, overlap about a foot. And then we'll start pushing the base out here. Get plenty of water in it. But we got the pin put back in the big excavator. Still needs to be welded up, but it's in there, so the tracks aren't gonna come apart now. That's a good thing.
That's good.
Yeah, we got her, pounded in about as good as she'll go right now. All right, so we got a couple of sheets of this felt rolled out right now, working on getting the third one. Got a 1 foot overlap. Got it tucked up on the sides there.
Get
that next one rolled out. Got to move this excavator out of the way. And then we'll. We're getting the first layer on right now. We got to wait for. Another load of the base. Got her about a foot right there. Coming in with pretty good moisture in it. I'm gonna go get the water hose out and give it a little shot.
Well, guys, what can I say? We did it. Or you guys did it. We hit 100,000 subscribers overnight, last night. And that's just an amazing thing for us. Never would have thought that was possible. Never would have believed it if we weren't here doing it. And it's just such a great thing for us, and we're so thankful for it. And we're gonna put a lot of effort into making this channel better, bringing better content, more variety of things. And the sky's the limit here, guys, so I just want to say thanks again for all that, and we're going to keep making these videos, and hope you guys enjoy. I'm going to get this one out right now.